Box 3, spool 5, spool 5, spool. Box. Spool. The black ball. The black ball? The dark nurse. Slight improvement in bowel condition. Memorable what? Equinox. Memorable equinox. Memorable equinox? Farewell to love.
Sound as a bell. Apart from my old weakness, and intellectually, I have now every reason to suspect that the crest of the wave, or thereabouts, celebrated the awful occasion, as in recent years, quietly at the wine house. Not a soul. Sat before the fire with closed eyes, separating the grain from the husks. Jotted down a few notes on the back of an envelope. Good to be back in my den, in my old rags. I've just eaten, I regret to say, 3 bananas, and only with difficulty refrained from a 4. Fatal thing. For a man with my condition. Cut him out! The new light above my table is a great improvement. With all this darkness around me, I feel less alone. In a way. I love to get up and move around here, then back here to me. Crap. The grave. Now, what I wonder do I mean by that? I suppose I mean those things worth having when all the dust has... When all my dust has settled, I close my eyes and try and imagine them. Extraordinary silence this evening. I strain my ears and do not hear a sound. Old Miss McGlone always sings at this hour. but not tonight. Songs of her girlhood, she says. Hard to think of her as a girl. Wonderful woman, though. Conic, I fancy. Shall I sing when I am her age? If I ever am. No. Did I sing as a boy? No. Did I ever sing? No. Just been listening to an old year. Passages at random. I did not check in the book, but it must be at least 10 or 12 years ago. At that time, I think I was still living on and off with Bianca in Kedder Street. Was that? Jesus, yes. Hopeless business. Not much about her, apart from a tribute to her eyes. Very warm. I suddenly saw them again. Incomparable. These old PMs are gruesome, but I often find them... A help before embarking on a new retrospect. Hard to believe I was ever that young. Well, the voice, Jesus, and the aspiration, and the resolution to drink less, in particular. Out of the preceding 8,000 odd consumed on licensed premises alone, more than 20%, say 40% of his waking life. Planned for a less engrossing sexual life, last illness of his father, flagging pursuit of happiness, unattainable laxation, sneers at what he calls his youth, and thanks to God that it's over. False reading there. Shadows of the Opus Magnum. Closing with a... Yelp to Providence. What remains of all that misery? A girl in a shabby green coat on a railway station platform? No? back on the year that is gone, with what I hope is perhaps a glimpse of the old eye to come. There is, of course, the house on the canal where Mother lay a-dying in the late autumn, after her long viduity and the...
State or condition of being or remaining a widow or widower. Being or remaining. Deep weeds of viduity. As though of an animal, especially a bird. The vidua, or weaver bird. Black plumage of male. Vidua bird.
Bench by the weir was where I could see her window. There I sat in the biting wind, wishing she were gone. Hardly a soul, just a few regulars, nursemaids, infants, old men, dogs. I got to know them quite well. Oh, by appearance, of course, I mean. One dark young beauty I recollect particularly. All white, starch. Incomparable bosom, with a big black hooded perambulator. Most funereal thing. Whenever I looked in her direction, she had her eyes. And yet, when I was bold enough to speak to her, not having been introduced, she threatened to call a policeman, as if I had designs on her virtue. The face she had, the eyes, like chrysalite. I was there with and the blind went down. One of those dirty brown roller affairs. Throwing a ball for a little white dog this chance would have. I happened to look up, and there it was. All over and done with. At last. I sat on for a few moments with the ball in my hand, and the dog yelping and pawing at me. Moments. Her moments. My moments. The dog's moments. In the end, I held it out to him, and he took it in his mouth, gently, gently. A small, old, black, hard, solid rubber ball. I shall feel it in my hand until my dying day. I might have kept it. But I gave it to the dog. Spiritually, a year of profound gloom and indigence until that memorable night in March, at the end of the day, in the howling wind, never to be forgotten when suddenly I saw the whole thing, the vision at last. This, I fancy, is what I have chiefly to record this evening, against the day when my work will be done, and perhaps no place left in my memory, warm or cold, for the miracle that, for the fire that it set alight. What I suddenly saw then was this, that the belief I had been going on all my life, namely, great black rocks, the foam flying up in the light of the lighthouse and the wind gauge spinning like a propeller. Clear to me at last that the dark I have always struggled to keep under is in reality my most unshatterable association until my dissolution of storm and night with the light of the understanding and the fire. My face in her breast, and my hand on her. We lay there without moving, but under us all moved, and moved us, gently, up and down, and from side to side. Past midnight. Never knew such silence. The earth might be uninhabited. Here I am. Upper lake, with the punt, bathed off the bank, then pushed out into the stream and drifted. She lay stretched out on the floorboards, with her hands under her head and her eyes closed. Sun blazing down, bit of a breeze. Water, nice and lively. I noticed a scratch on her thigh and asked her how she came by it. Picking gooseberries, she said. I said again, I thought it was hopeless and no good going on, and she agreed, without opening her eyes. I asked her to look at me, and after a few moments, she did, but the eyes just slits because of the glare. I bent over her to get them in the shadow, and they opened. Let me in. We drifted in among the flags and stuck. The way they went down, sighing before the stem. I lay down across her, with my face in her breast and my hand on her. We lay there without moving, but under us, all moved, and moved us, gently, up and down, and from side to side. Past midnight. Never noon. Thank you.
just been listening to that stupid bastard I took myself for 30 years ago. Hard to believe I was ever as bad as that. Thank God that's all done with anyway. The eyes she has. Everything there. Everything. Everything there. Everything on this old muck ball. Oh, the light, dark, famine, feasting of the ages. Yes! Let that go. Jesus. Take his mind off his homework. Jesus! Nothing you say. Not a squeak. What's a year now? The sour cut and the iron stool. Reveled in the word spool. Copies sold. 11 of which at trade price to free circulating libraries beyond the seas. Getting. No. £1.06. Eight, and little doubt. Crawled out once or twice, oh, the summer got cold. Sat, shivering in the park, drowned in dreams and burning for it to be over. Not a soul. last fancies. I'll keep them under! Scalded the eyes out of me, reading Effie again. Page a day, with tears again. Effie. Could have been happy with her, up there on the Baltic. The pines, the dunes. Could I? And she? Fanny came over a couple of times. Bony old ghost of a whore. Couldn't do much better than a kick in the crutch. Last time wasn't so bad. How do you manage it? She said. At your age! Told her I'd been saving up for her all my life. Went to Vespers once, back when I was in short trousers. Went to sleep and fell off the pew. Sometimes I wonder at night, the last effort, my own. Finish your booze and go to your bed. Go on with this dribble in the morning. I'll leave it. Lie propped up in the dark, wander, be again in the dingle on Christmas Eve, gathering holly, the red buried, be again on Poen on a Sunday morning. Misery. Once wasn't enough for you.
Gooseberry, she said. I said again, I thought it was hopeless and no good going on, and she agreed, without opening her eyes. I asked her to look at me, and after a few moments, she did, but the eyes just slits because of the glare. I bent over her to get them in the shadow, and they opened. We drifted in among the flags and stuck. The way they went down, sighing before the stem. I lay down across her, with my face in her breast and my hand on her. We lay there without moving, but under us all moved, and moved us, gently, up and down, and from side to side. Past midnight. Never knew such silence. The earth might be uninhabited. Here I end this reel. Box 3. Spool 5. Perhaps my best years are gone, when there was a chance of happiness, but I wouldn't want them back. Not with the fire in me now. No, I wouldn't want them back.